Dare to Dream. We are 10 years of age, tankers. Jennifer Keegan's Dare to Team from Douglas. Jennifer and Tank. Pet name is Tank. 10-year-old Papillon. Competed in the Young Kennel Club across the last 3 years. First time in the main arena. It's going to be his last competitive run, this one. Tank, the 10-year-old Papillon, determined to go out on a high. Through the weaves and the left-hander to the wall and the little tight right-hander taking Tank through the tunnel. Tidy over the dog walk. Good opening round for Jennifer and for Tank. Where did it go now? Just there, again with a slight bit of hesitation, but it's okay and it's clean. And then there will be the handover at the end of it. Right now, that's good. Good clear round and the time very respectable as well. Jane Wilkinson and Betsy, 7-year-old Border Terrier, third time at Crofts, can be a bit of a loner at home, but put an agility course in front of her and she comes alive.
She does. They all come alive on an agility course, having such a good time out there. I'm not quite so sure about the handlers when you're in a team competition here at Crufts at the biggest and best dog show in the world, but she's having a ball into that tunnel, and now it's a really fast approach onto the dog walk. No time wasted at all now. Round onto the next piece of control equipment. Now again a chance, so to stretch out, it's all about a little bit of control, a little bit of speed, a little bit of control again. That's what we've got here now. This is a nice fast finish into the box for the changeover.
Changeover to Hayley Tindall and Fifi, 8-year-olds at Toy Poodle, and Dare to Dream are going really, really well at the moment. They are right up there in contention. The time is very, very good, and there are no faults on the clock as yet. So this could be good with just the one dog to run after this. And Hayley and Fifi flying through the weaves, scampering in front of us. Great sight over that dog walk. Crowd loving that. Takes the obstacles really well, does Fifi. And there, this team, Dare to Dream, are right in the mix with one to go. And that is Sarah Peel and Megan, 8-year-old Jack Russell, third time at Crofts, last year doing team event. And can they put themselves right up in contention here? I think the time is going to be a little bit slower than Up and Over Tigers. But this is really good, and Sarah and Megan maintaining the standard. Might not be the fastest dog we've seen, Megan, but it's so important to keep that zero next to the time. Just a couple to go now towards the end of the course, and it's a good time. 185.1 and clean and good enough for second place.
And I think it's probably fair to say that in any other year, apart from this year, that would have been good enough to win. Four clear rounds is no mean feat. To get one dog round here in this environment is a good achievement. To get four round clear is absolutely amazing. So well done to them.
The lady to go will be Tracy Ryan, working Izzy, a Sprocker Spaniel. 4 years of age, is his first time at Crufts. She was rehomed at 7 months, was far too large for her previous owner. She took to agility straight away and loves training with Leslie Olden.
Two to go.
Great place to go.
Nedlow Small from West Parley in Hampshire. Tracy Ryan, Izzy, 4-year-old Cocker Spaniel, first time at Crufts. Was rehomed at 7 months, too lively for her previous owners, but agility sorted Izzy out. She took to it straight away. Just loves it and loves all the training as well. Good start for Tracy and a good start to Izzy. This is the penultimate team, remember. Just one to go after this. And that unbelievable time set by Up and Over Tigers, 161 is the time they are all aiming for. Just picking up the 5 volts. Izzy and Tracy, Chantal Hutton with Buzz, 4-year-old Shetland sheepdog from Whirlwell near Andover, can be a nervous dog. This one, first time at Crofts Grand.
It is, so with that combination, it is a big ask here, but so as you say, she'll be just concentrating now on giving the dog every encouragement she can, saying, don't be worried, don't worry about this green carpet, these lights, this big crowd, just come on and concentrate on me and have fun like we do every week at the training field. And she's doing a really good job here to keep the dogs focused. And this is where sometimes it can be a little frustrating, because you know that week on, week out, they go just that little bit faster, but now the dog's just a little bit unsure. But you can see it's picking up speed as it gets around this course. She's doing a really, really good job. We've got a nice tight turn now. Oh, just looking at the finish. One more good turn back into that box, and then yes, there we go. Well done. Good, looking for a good changeover.
Chantal Hutton handing over to Jack Ryan, and Jet Rehome. Jet loves his agility, competed for Team GB at the Junior European Opens for the last 3 years. So Jack Ryan, one of the very promising young handlers, and Jet's 6-year-old Pomeranian.
Yes, Jack's been around for quite a long time now, and if you're sat at home with a really, really small dog thinking, my dog can't do agility, look at this. Absolutely has a great time. The only problem is it has to go right to the end of the seesaw to get it to tip, and he did that really, really quickly. The dog's obviously learned that it needs to go right the way up. If you stop early, you're in trouble. But this is a fantastic round here by Jack.
Just five faults for Jack, 145 seconds on the clock. Last to go, April Britton and Halo, four-year-old Shetland sheepdog, first time at Crufts. Been competing for a couple of years. Import from Belgium is Halo, the Shetland sheepdog. Love seeing the dog go through those weaves, pointing towards the tunnel. April, dog walk, picking up a bit of speed over that, made the contact point as well. That probably the quickest part of the course on that far side, once they've negotiated that seesaw. Getting a tight turn. And Nedlow Small. 184 under five faults, up into fourth place at the moment, Graham.
Yes, really good effort, just an unlucky contact fault. And there we are, clearly didn't make contact with the white area, picking up the only fault of the round.
And guess what, they're from Scotland.
Look at that dog having a ball there.
There you go. I like these orange tops. I tend to watch the dogs go round, but unfortunately sometimes yesterday I had this with the orange tops.
Last team to go, XL Dog Agility. Mini Mayhem from Livingston, West Lothian. Big support for every competitor north of the border. Pamela Lawson and Ellie, four-year-old Parson Terrier. Wonderful way to spend her birthday today with Ellie, who's 4 years old and competing at Crufts for the very first time. So happy birthday to Pamela. And just a reminder, the team to beat up and over Tigers, and the time to beat 161 seconds, and they cannot afford any faults as well, and they certainly cannot afford the horrible crossed arms, Graham.
No, they can't. That will incur 100 faults, and they must now go on to complete this course correctly, otherwise the whole team will be eliminated, and that's it's done like that to save a dog shortcutting back to the finish and getting a really, really good time. So that's not a particularly good start, not the start they would have wanted.
Next to go, Tracy Barton and Harry, 8-year-old Jack Russell. First agility dog for Tracy. Named after Harry Potter. So we will look and see what this is of expertise and unrivaled magic. Can be produced there, and that's a little bit of a hesitation, but it's okay. Tracy and Harry. Far end of the course, Harry tail wagging. As we always say here, if they could talk, they'd say we're absolutely loving this, and that's a good round from Tracy and Harry. Very respectable. Derek Elms next to go. With 5-year-old Bunty, rescued at 6 weeks, and has won 2 reserve championship tickets since competing. Picking up a couple of early faults there. Derek and Bunty. So the last team to go in the small agility relay that's got things underway here on International Saturday at Crux 2019, and we're about to see the last competitor enter the ring when the handover occurs for the XL Dog Agility from Edinburgh. Michelle Henderson and Pinto, eight-year-old toy poodle. First year, Pinto's qualified for the small championship class at Crufts. Talk us through the climax of the competition.
There we are. You see the handler there turning and twisting, making sure that she connects with the dog, always looking over her shoulder when she changes sides in front of the dog. The dog has to know where it's going. These dogs don't know where they're going. The only person who knows is the handler, and the dogs are totally reliant on the handler for all their commands. They can do anything they want, but they can't touch the dog. They indicate to the dog which way they're going by verbal commands. They use their shoulders, they use their arms, their hands. And look at this, all just a little bit of confusion there. Now she's on the wrong side, now confusion reigns. So it's just a bit of time, no faults there, but well done, good finish.
That is leading to the elimination. And final images of the competition that has got the third day underway here at Crufts. Confirmation, up and over Tigers, different class really, faultless and the quickest by a considerable distance, Dare to Dream next best, and then Cornforth United Northern teams in the top three. Nido Small, Ace Poodle Mix rounding up the top five. And that completes the result of the agility relay. A fantastic day ahead of us here, up and over Tigers, the talk of the main arena at the moment.
Good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Ladies and gentlemen, it's presentation time!
And it's presentation time, and there we see our judge, Hilary Bowden, just stepping into the middle, and she is flanked by Anne Roberts and Maria Johnson. Well, she's not flanked now, but we've got Maria Johnson and Anne Roberts, who are both volunteers. They come here every year to help organise the trophies and rosettes, and they do an absolutely fantastic job, so thank you very much indeed, ladies. So we've got the two teams in the arena, and the presentation to the winner, which was Up and Over Tigers. And they absolutely smashed this competition this year.
Look what I've got for you.
And it was Katie Beauchamp, Selena Bray,
and then
her father. So that's Selena getting hers. Lauren Langman will be next. So with Blink. Blink in the Blink collar there, that's Lauren.
Which is a first for me.
And last but not least, the very experienced Mr. Alan Bray. He's won just about everything there is to be won in agility over a number of years with both large, small and medium dogs. And now we come to the runner-up. And that was the team of Dare to Dream. And I have to say that they were very, very unlucky this year to come up a team like the Up and Over Tigers. I think any other year, the round that this team put in would have won. And the team consisted of Jennifer Keegans, Jane Wilkinson, Hayley Tindall and Sarah Peel. So well done to them. Very well reserved.
So here we go. It's Lap of Honour time.
Here we go now. Off onto Lap of Honour time.